everybody, welcome back to Divinity, Original Sin, the Enhanced Edition. We're back where we were last episode, episode 18 I believe. We're now on episode 19 I think. So we're now approaching the older church. Let's try and enter and see what these statues have to say.
Try to enter the church. The statues that flank its heavy oaken doors address you.
Hold your horses, stranger. This holy hall may be entered by those who are loyal to the goddess only. And even eyes of stone can see you are no such creature.
Oh, I wish to enter the
it
church.
It is a wish we cannot grant unless you prove you have knowledge of the goddess. Answer us, therefore, the following question. How is she known among the loyal, the exalted one, she who speaks for the goddess?
What have we got? Intimidate, charm, reason, and we've got no advantage on any, so let's try charm. Here we go. Damn it. Okay, that's the way it's going to be, is it? Oh, for God's sake. Okay, it looks like we're going to be fighting them.
You flatter with a serpent's tongue, and we shall not be deceived. Now stone will break your bones.
All right, here we go. We are fighting the stone statues. They look pretty sweet, don't they? This should be fun. Right, piercing against these isn't going to be very good, I don't think. No, absolutely useless. See if we can attract their attention, shall we?
See how fast she scuttles!
Move over there a little bit, thank you. Right. Examine. 20% crushing. 50%. Alright, we can't do anything else with her. Slashing. 31 to 70. Equip that for the time being. Oh, that's okay. Right. Come on, Spidey. Don't think that'll work, but we'll try it. Oh, we did work. Well. No damage whatsoever. Great.
Not so fast.
Where does he think he's going?
Though not half so bloody.
Okay. What do you say it was weak to? Poison? And crushing. All the rest are no good whatsoever. Poison arrow.
I think it's time for your
medicine. Immune to poison. Alrighty then. Alright. Air damage, wasn't it? What have we got here? Water, air. Equip. Ooh, yes, that's better. Fire damage. Water, air. It looks more like it. Let's see if that'll freeze this one.
Glacial gust.
And yes, it did. Right.
Vicious vortex.
Life roils within these veins.
I wonder if I can charm one of these. I'll try that next turn.
Dynamic force!
Right, come on, Medora. Let's see what you've got. Nice damage, nice.
Oh, how I'll sing of your entrails.
No, don't miss. 1800 experience, that's very nice. Stunned, excellent. Need to throw a little heal onto Medora, if possible. Let's try a silver arrow, shall we? Reduce armor. Well, let's see if this will work.
Your service pleases me greatly.
Oh, yes. Awesome. Well,
my curses
cursed
upon you.
And weak. Very nice. Go, Spidey. No damage whatsoever. And lightning should do well. Yes, stunned. Lovely, lovely. This is working out very well. Alright, go that way. And that way.
I'll defend you till my death rattle.
Get him blocked in. Oh. Lowers armor for 3 turns. Miss. Excellent. Bless Medora.
Divine blessing.
And armor up, Medora.
Guard your loins!
Gird your loins, even. Right. Right, Spidey's gone. Don't really want to go in that poison, do we? How about we attack him instead? There we go.
I'll make short work of this scam.
It's very nice of you to come into range. Right, Bedalter, your turn now to be a total waste of space in this scenario, so just do what you have to do and stop doing anything. Heal on Medora.
Try to resist this, worm!
Stand down before I put you down!
Anything else we can use? It would appear not. Get a fire off, I suppose. Yeah, nothing. Right. I see that did damage. That's not bad, that. We can put up with that.
Oh, the man.
Decaying touch. That's not good against these, I don't think. They're not going to be healing. Let's get him up there. Can help us out a little bit. I should kill you.
Seven, have mercy on your soul.
I feel like I've been set in stone.
Ouch. Ouch.
Into the fray once more.
Oh, sugar. What are you doing, Nick? back off again. Thank you. Really? Electric.
Blitzbolt!
Stunning failed.
Magical blows.
Oh, so close. You get the honor, Skelly. Nice, there we go. Don't often have to do that fight, but it comes in very handy. To get a little bit of experience. And we've got some nice stuff here by the look of it. Come on. Barrage. was for Bear Daughter, if I remember correctly.
Ooh!
Ooh! Right, 97 to 120. Durability, 1 of 1, so you can use it once. Irreparable. Hmm, there's only one person who could use that, that's Medora. Winds of Change. Send that to their daughter. Right, and we're going into Braccus's dens pretty soon, so we need fire's gonna be no good. I recommend water is probably the best thing for us. Does that do? Strength and shield specialist. It's not as good. Oh, we could go for the damage. It's air. Let's put the water on. All this should be with Roderick, really. And he had a skill book as well, didn't he? There he is, Bear Daughter. Very nice. Let's put that there. What's the perception at? 9. We'll go down to 8. I think we can live with that for the time being. We'll hang on to that though. And Scarlet is air. Right, I think we can live with that. Seems fine. Right, let's enter and put a little save in.
Ah, Source Hunter. Have you come to lend your blood to our cause? How much simpler all this would be if only it was so. Still, I cannot blame you for struggling against me. What reason have you to trust me that your efforts are misplaced? But now, with Braccus Rex nearly risen, there's little more you can do to hinder me.
Hinder you? I hardly understand what you're trying to accomplish.
Perhaps for the better. When we first met on the beaches of Sicyl, I underestimated you. That blunder has cost me dearly. Still, after all, you need not know more than this. The end is coming. The end of sorrow. The end of pain. Those who oppose me oppose peace itself.
Why would you hope to attain this peace?
And here I thought you'd seen it yourself. Tell me, what is the imp historian doing, if not begging you to divert the void?
The Void Maelstrom? Are you the one compelling it closer?
So, you're familiar after all. You know as well as I that the Void is coming. In fact, if I'm very precise, it's already here. But you need not be afraid. The Void is ourselves. We are destined to rejoin it.
Am I imagining this, or is that the voice? From Dragon Age 2 and Dragon Age What was she called? The mother of the character you controlled. I can't think of the name at the moment. All right, never mind. I'll come back to that later.
I have chosen a dark and dangerous path, but I vow that those sacrificed have not suffered in vain. My only wish for all of Revelon is the soft hush of silence.
If your goal is to unleash the void on Revelon, what use have you for the Source King?
Braccus Rex was the forefather of our cause, the original Immaculate. His resurrection brings Revelon one step closer to the ultimate solution. Dissolution. Wouldn't you like to meet him? The sorcerer your order was formed to destroy. I'm certain he'd love nothing more than to meet you. Follow me. Find out.
Oh, what is the name of that woman from Dragon Age? Oh, that's gonna bug me immensely. Okay, that's updated. That's been updated. And they're gonna wanna fight, so might as well start it. There you go. What shall we do first? Oh, that gets all three. Very nice. Oiled. Just get it? Yes. Nice. Nice damage. And what have we got to offer here? Do I want to get Nick out? Do I need him? Now let's hit him with a fireball, shall we?
Eternal silence awaits you.
Yes, I think so. 3,600 XP. Very nice. Come on, Midora. Morrigan. Morrigan's mother was the attorney to the dragon. That was the voice of her, I'm sure it was. So I knew it would come to me eventually. Who's next? Might be able to reach with that if we look at you. Yeah.
Wrath of the Magi!
Right, let's see what we've got to pick up here now. To Medora, we know that'll be good for her, and that'll be no stats on it. Right, anything else we need? Right, painting of a landscape.
A hidden switch.
There's one.
Perhaps it has something to do with opening that hatch. A switch, much like the first. Could there be more?
Church gate key, I need that.
Three down, but how many to go?
Just one more to go, I do believe. Got the gate key now, we're going there. Plenty of stuff to identify. Her daughter, Scarlet. Right, gold cup for selling. Key, that would be for the chest that we can unlock. And the painting.
What was that? I heard the sound of scraping in the main hall.
Alright, let's release that. Where's the chest that we couldn't get? That one, was it? No. That one, I believe. Thank you, mate. All right, I think there used to be a hatch or something in here. Let's get her bear daughter. Now it's gonna take another one off perception. Let's pull the extra perception on for a minute.
What's this? I found something.
There we go, we see. 9 perception needed to get that by the look of it. Hatch.
Wow. Hello there. And who, pray tell, might you be?
Most recognise us as the Source Hunters. Who are you?
Oh, let's just say I keep the place in check. Tidy it up.
What's this? A soap? Really? Haven't you got a name?
I'm no one important, really. I've learned to appreciate anonymity. And forgive me if I prefer to distance myself from any possible mishaps you adventurers can cause. Quite unpleasant to get involved. Authorities knocking on your door in the middle of the night and so on.
It sounds like you had some bad experiences with adventurers.
Forgive me if I generalise, but some of your lot are as crazy as they come. I once thought you a quaint sort, but over the years I've come to realise that about 1 in 10 is downright dangerous. Lock up behind bars, paint the key blue and toss it into the sea material. Now I can't help but wonder, are you cut from the same batty cloth? Why've you come here after all? What's the point of it all?
The mysterious stranger gives you a long look and, after what feels like a vast eternity, nods.
Okay.
Okay to you as well. All right, let's check these. Bed also gets a lot of gear to use. Oh, and there's something else over here.
Thank you.
52 armor. Send it to her just in case. And that. Quick look. 52. One initiative. 14%. Blue's got an immunity fear. Okay, we'll keep that. Definitely keep that. What's that? 27 to 45 water. That's water. Alright, I can go to Roderick. Ooh, that needs repairing. Alright, that'll do for the time being, I think. Right. Let us head down the stairs, shall we? I think we got everything from around here. Yeah, I'm all certain we did. Ancient tomb. Holy hand grenade. That's my door, I think, for a change.
Strange magic here. How will we deactivate it?
Just approach it, should work.
Must have used some kind of key or spell to get through.
Oh no, maybe I haven't got it equipped anymore. Maybe that'll do it.
The Immaculate Amulet fits perfectly inside.
All right, it was easy as that, was it? Right, okay. quit that.
I'm a fool. Please. You must stop. Source Hunter. By the health of the Seven, you're here. There may yet be hope. Perhaps you remember me as a healer. But gods, what a herald of death I've become. I'm beyond redemption now. But you alone may save Cyseal, may save all of Rivelon from the horror I've summoned. King Braccus. Braccus Rex from the tales of old. He lives. The mad Source King, the Lord of Chaos. I have awakened him. I've done
what
a terrible thing. I've raised a mad king from beyond the grave. I imagined so very foolishly that I'd be able to extract an ancient secret from him. But with a simple flash of his arcane magic, I was finished.
Do you have anything I can use? Take that. Take those. What can I give you in return? There we go. Thank you, Theron, before you die. I have many questions about this King Braccus.
I'll tell you all I know, Source Hunter.
What do you mean you've awakened a long dead king? We know what that
resurrected,
means.
Resurrected, revived. The king lives, but not as the man he once was. he retains the mark of death upon him, like a festering wound.
Who is or was King Braccus?
The last of the mad Source Kings he was. But the tyrant who nearly condemned Rivellon to oblivion. He began the War of Wars, marching brother against friend, until every land and home burned with death. It was during this dark time that your order, the Source Hunters, was formed. Braccus was defeated, and Source outlawed from the land.
Why did you win?
Braccus was a dangerous monster, but he achieved things no man or mortal could have dreamt of. He alone is said to have known a great secret, how to break the Forge of Souls. I promised to extract this secret for a woman calling herself the Conduit. In exchange, she vowed to reveal to me a certain power of her own. In hindsight, I see that I dealt with the devil, and I've received my damnation.
How did you call him forth from the land of the dead?
I was given a great stone. A bloodstone, but more charged with life than any I'd seen before. The Conduit said it would imbue Braccus with life enough to share the secret she craved. But what he has become, his powers have all returned, and I cannot stop him.
So it was you who raised the undead around Sicily.
My failures are so many, I can hide them no longer. In my pursuit of the Source King, I've called forth abominations that neither I nor any other can destroy. The ghoul that guards the lighthouse, the Baron of Bones, the twins by fire joined. Their ghastly faces haunt me, and they in turn have rifled through the graves and sarcophagi of Sicile in search of undead minions. Undead, Source Hunter, unkillable. I fear this plague may never end, no matter how many times the rotten dead are defeated.
Well, let me ask you about the Conduit.
Curse her name, her hell-sent promises. She claims to be a link between her goddess and the world of men. I never believed her divine claims, but I could not deny her great power. It was she who showed me that Bloodstone could be used for more than healing. Her stones, particularly powerful and potent, could raise the dead.
What did the Conduit promise you in return for your help?
What could turn any soft soul towards wickedness? My weakness was love, and it was love that she promised me. The Conduit had shown me how to raise skeletons and zombies from their graves. But what I craved was something far more rare, a second life. A true second life for my wife, Malia. She was a beautiful soul, snatched from the world of the living far before her time. Now the Conduit's promise seemed simple, a secret for a secret. I'd tell her how to break the Soul Forge, and she'd tell me how to bring Malia back.
Okay, I'll take my leave, thank you.
You can defeat the unholiness I've raised, Source Hunter. You can save the countless innocents that will perish under the Source King's mad fist. I pray... No, I believe you can reverse my failures.
Alrighty then. Okay, that's updated, that's updated. And we now have a Forge of Souls. Time to talk.
Theliron believed that by unleashing these monsters, he'd learn the secret to resurrecting his beloved wife.
Love so complete can cloud even the best man's judgment.
Aye. In Theliron's position, I'd wager many of us would do the same.
Oh, we're forgiving. That's very nice of us, isn't it? Right. I say, before I open that door... What, he's doing it for me? Okay. Where are you?
Here now, one who comes to watch the spectacle, to see the sovereign of the source ascend again. Or perhaps you are the first in a long new line, the first that will try to stop my dominion again.
Just moving my people around a little bit. Hope this works. If not, we're in trouble.
Oh, by the emerald eyes of the goddess, would you believe that I can still feel it ever so vaguely? The force of the stab that cleft my heart and sent my soul shivering into death. But my followers have done it. They have done it like I knew they would. Blood, the thick red gravy, the source of souls, has been yielded unto stars and stones and has swept away the eternal shadows. How long has it been, I wonder, my first repose in death? An hour? The time it takes the seas to tear down cliffs, it is of no matter. I live, and I shall claim my throne anew.
You are the fabled Braccus Rex, I presume.
A fable I may have become as time dragged on, but a fact I am once more, little one. Don't all of you miserable mortals realize that they who are one with Source have thrown off the burdensome mantle of death forever. I embraced Source. I drank it, made it part of my blood and my being. And so a warlord became a sorcerer, and a sorcerer became a king. The fools of this world dubbed me a tyrant, but the gods convinced them I was such, fearful as they were of my rise. Power. Armies amassed. Too many. Scores I slew. Too few. Death took me. Too soon. But not for all time.
Tell me, what does the name Cassandra mean to you?
Ha! Not a thing. There was a woman once that went by that name. Until I mangled her body into that of a lich. Oh, my sister dearest. Cassandra. Man-cat. Mere pets of mine, the both of them. Tools to bruise and break as I saw fit. They bled so very beautifully.
I'm told the reason for your resurrection is a secret you hold. How to break a soul forge.
The reason for my resurrection, O simplest of spirits, is that I was destined to be. Were it not for the vainglorious fools that raised me now, it would have been another, perhaps wiser being, that would have done so in time. And time is of no matter, only to be. Eternally, a woman seeks my secret, for her soul is entwined with another's. Yes, where once they were inseparable, now they have grown apart in purpose and intent. But my secrets are mine to keep. Perhaps when she lies shivering before me, pledging alliance to her king, I will break her forge before I break her.
All right, I've heard enough. We saw Sons undid you once and we will do so again.
A source hunter. So you are, though you are so much more, and do not even know it. No matter, they still smell like you do, by the by, your brother and sister hunters, as they closed in around me that first time. Fear that most sly, most intangible of scents. Drowned out soon afterward by the acid stench of urine. I had but to look at them, and they rusted in their chainmail where they stood. I undid so manifold they had to wade through the gore of the fallen. Oh, what a feast, what fountains of gravy we had. Alas, that there were too many, as there clearly are too many of you still. Although, life renewed has made me rather peckish. And from the looks of you, you need but the slightest of squeezes to make squirt the sauce's sauce from your soft, fleshy shell.
Man, this man is gross.
Yes, look at you. Plump as a leech, bulging with freshly sucked blood. Oh, I do believe, as my servants would say as they brought in a squirming, plump girl on a plate, that dinner is served.
Okie dokie. Here we go.
Stand by you.
Okay, that's not the start I was hoping for. What else have we got? Oh, he's heading for the fire. Wow. All right, first things first. Heal on the go. That's all we can do there, I think.
Sweet relief.
I don't think that will reach, so we'll try freezing arrow. Damn it. Six damage though, that's nice. No. How are we doing? Freezing failed. No.
comrades. We are
okay, that's a bonus. We're doing well
levels
here now, I think. Ish. Damn it.
Oh, I needed that. Fiendish force!
Can't reach. Let's bless Bear Daughter.
Divine section!
Sweet relief.
Can't reach. Oh, so close. Right. You need to stay down. You really do. Oh. Right, one down. Right. Let's get this down.
Rainfall!
I'm drenched!
That's 106 damage. Freezing arrow. And he's frozen. Excellent. Right, you can move up a little bit. As can you. Need to move up as far as possible, really. You go and take the care of this dude. Thank you. Nice, nice damage. Armor up.
Armor of the Seven.
Okay, things aren't going too badly at all. Go on, Medora. Damn it. What can we do here now? How many turns is she down for? 3 turns. Alright, we'll forget that then for a minute. Get a heal on her. their daughter some extra attack. +231 damage. Oh, we can have one of those, I think.
Crystallizing arrow!
Get rid of you.
Dynamic force!
I needed that.
What we need. Oh, and he's up. So we need to do something quick. That might not be enough. Nope. Ice shard. And there we go.
And that is the final end of Braccus Rex.
May his soul remain in the depths of hell for good.
Ouch. Okay, we need a heal. Again. No, she's alright. What can we do to you? Fire is your enemy. Right, okay. So close. Go on. Come on, Medora. Damn it. Oh, there we go. Burning got him. Well, that was fairly painless apart from the start, just learning losing Roderick. Right. Get some healing on the go, shall we? Right, that goes with that, that goes with that.
I feel better already.
It is strange, Source Hunter. I have heard many tales of Braccus Rex, the radiant ruler, and King Braccus, boon of our blighted land.
How can it be that the stories sang him a hero when he was in fact an evil tyrant?
History is written by power, not by truth. That's very, very true.
But you cannot think that all the stories of old are fiction. What about Thrys? What about Amira? And the cycles of the elven bards? If they are false, if they are written by power, as you say, what good can they be? A wise man such as Jarrett would not have bothered with propaganda, as you say. He's a man of learning. No. I am certain you are wrong in this, Source Hunter.
I'm afraid that Bear Daughter, you're going to learn the truth about your friend Jareth at some point in the story. Right, we're all healed. Just Medora a little bit. Right, let's just have a look at what goodies we have. Got some nice stuff here by the look of it. Anything in this? I'll have a quick looting session all around, I think. Not much going on in all this, is there? Summon fire elemental. Yes, please. That's another room unlocked. We need to go back to the end of time pretty soon. Identify. Yeah, that's a... That's a Medora thing, I think. Damage. Keep that one. That's a Medora. Charm scroll. See, it's worth checking all these little pots and vases that you find. Birdwater, come over here, please. There we go. Now, have you got what I think you've got? Who are we on? Scarlet. Now, Birdwater, I'm sure she had an unlock scroll on her. Or somebody did. Strange. Could have sworn one of them had it. Okay, would appear not, so we cannot open that. At the time being. Okay, anything else we've missed? A few pots over here. A cup of tea.
Source Hunter. Is it safe? Have you done it? Please tell me that you have sent Braccus Rex to the grave once and for all.
So I have. His reign of terror is over forever. But I need something off you if you got it. of course you haven't. That's a shame. Not to worry.
Magnificent. Oh, truly wondrous. I feel like a prisoner set free. Free to bask in the daylight once more. I was so fearful. Petrified almost in the knowledge that I might see him again. You see, I knew the Mad King. In fact, I served him. I'm a wizard hunter. And that means I've seen many centuries pass me by. They weren't always happy ones. And you may take that as an understatement.
I was once under Braccus' thrall, bound to him by perfidious magic. Life was an endless cycle of servitude, torture, and humiliation. Only after the first Source Hunter skewered him like the pig he was did my nightmare end. As you can imagine, I was afraid beyond all measure that the fiend would enslave us all once more. That I'd be cast back into the rank pit that was my past. But he hasn't, and he never will. Thank you. I will never forget this act of valor.
I asked Braccus about Cassandra. It turns out she was his sister. A sister with a man cat.
So you have heard of her? Yes. I knew Cassandra. She was a sweet girl when we met. Hardly a woman yet. The very opposite of her deranged brother, who did not hesitate to butcher her for his own benefit. We were fast friends in those days. Aye, more than friends. Until he took her down to the dungeons, and she returned a woman no longer. A twisted lich had she become, with a twisted mind to match her grisly new shape.
Why did Braccus turn his own sister into a lich?
He remorselessly and relentlessly sought ways to cheat death. Cassandra and he were soul-forged, so he knew that if she would die, he would die. And so he turned her into a lich. Turned her into a creature neither living nor dead, so that he could break the soul forge without destroying himself in the process. Giving the matter no further thought, he rid his sister of her humanity, so as to rid himself of a spell that could threaten him. Such a man was Braccus Rex. Immortal in his mind, and immortal to be in effect. As your swords and spells have demonstrated, though, to this world's everlasting contentment, his deranged fancy was not to be.
If Cassandra is an immortal lich, where is she now?
I don't know. When the Source Hunters besieged Braccus' castle, I sought only to escape. I never heard of her again.
Truly, even though, as you say, you and Cassandra were more than friends?
Yes. I longed for freedom, for release. When I saw my chance, I ran and never looked back.
So now that Braccus has been dealt with, what's next?
You have foiled one of Leandra's vile designs. That much is certain. But I highly doubt you forestalled her endgame, whatever that may be. It is therefore imperative that we find her sister Ikara. As you've learned from the accursed duo that was Jake and Evelyn, the White Witch is somehow involved. I will vouch for her gentle nature, but alas, I cannot vouch for her current state of mind. Has she been corrupted by her sister, perhaps? Or have they become enemies locked in a murderous game of cat and mouse? There's no way of knowing until you find her. What I do know is that she lives in a cabin deep in Lakula Forest to the north. If anywhere, that is where I advise your travels should take you next.
Okay, I'll take my
leave. Very well, Hunter. My gratitude is yours, as is my service.
Nice. Find the witch, forge of souls, Cassandra. I'm dead. We completed that. Search for Braccus Rex. Right, so we need to go back to town. Oh, hang on. Another conversation.
That's it. Braccus Rex is dead. The way he spoke about our forebears was horrific. I wonder how many Source Hunters had to die before the Source King was deposed.
He was a man who was recruited by Source. Don't waste a moment thinking on his crimes, especially not when we have a world of work ahead of us.
Yes, forward is the only way we can look now. This Source cult runs deeper than we dreamed. We must stamp it out before another Braccus Rex rises.
Pragmatic. Okie dokie, aren't we? I'm check that. Are these? Right, so we'll call it there for the episode, folks. Braccus Rex is now gone. Oh, what's that? Resurrect scroll. We need to go back to the end of time. We also need to go back to town. I need to have a look at all this new equipment that we've just picked up and pass it out accordingly. And I won't bore you with that, so I will see you next episode. This is Olgrey, signing off.